Louise.
Hello.
Hi, darling. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. What do you do, Louise?
I work for a customer service for a company called Fantasy Entertainment.
Watch out, Louise. You already know we about to find out what that is. I don't know how you thought we were just going to blow through that. You, Louise?
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you tell us in your own words?
You're going to be disappointed.
I'm going to be disappointed.
They do photos in those little photo booth kiosks. Okay. I'm sorry.
Me. The little photo booths that's in the mall? Where y'all from again?
New Hampshire.
That's what y'all call Fantasy Entertainment? You know what Fantasy Entertainment is supposed to be? You're supposed to go in that booth, close that curtain, and oh, Lord, have mercy. Why are you crying, Louise?
Oh.
All right. Catherine.
Hi.
Hi, darling. How are you?
I'm fine.
Go ahead. What do you do?
I work retail part-time.
Okay, retail part-time.
Part-time, yeah, because I'm in between. Sometimes I like to go here, sometimes I like to go there. When they let me go from one job, I go to another job. I don't have one set job right now. I do something to keep myself busy during the day.
Girl, me too.
I know it.
You normally laugh the whole time you talking.
Oh, I know.
You oughta got to be the happiest person.
I ain't got no job.
I don't know. I ain't never seen unemployment be that funny before. I ain't got no job. I ain't worked in 4 years. They just cut the lights off Friday. We hungry. Name something a person might be holding that's about 12 inches.
A man's private part.
You never know. That could be a good thing.
I already know. Every game we play, when there's a little nasty answer, I come right to the twins. Ain't no way in the world a boy in a huddle with his mama and that's the answer he come up with. That answer has to come from the mama and the twin sister, because the son is not gonna ever say that in front of the mama. I already know that for a fact. Which one of you said it? I already know. It was her, wasn't
it? Crazy.
You know, when you play with a family these many shows in a row, you get to kind of know the family. I came right down here. You ain't gonna say that to your mama. This has to be your mother's idea. A man's private parts. Name something a female dog might think a male dog does in a sexy way. Halua.
Sniffer.
I know that's right.
Got a sniff test.
Sniff her.
How he goes to the bathroom.
How he goes to the bathroom.
Okay. Yeah. Attractive.
How you like that? Yeah. How you like me now? Yeah, you ain't think I was nothing a minute ago. How about now, baby? Huh? How about now? Go to the bathroom. Name something a female dog might think a male dog does in a sexy way.
Humps her.
Mm. That's nice.
Well, I do.
You don't know what he said, humps her. You want me to show you how that go too?
Right,
I'm not really showed you how he lift the bathroom. Don't make me do the hump thing. Come on, Judge. Act like you know what I'm talking. You know, and why he's showing her the bathroom move. That would really get good.
In that order, Steve. Peach, sniff, hump.
Hey!
Go!
Thank you, man.
That's my favorite answer. Name a word that rhymes with winner. Jennifer.
Winner.
That rhyme with it, though. Sound exactly. Watch this here. Winner, winner!
It's not up there.
Jennifer said, it's not up there, Steve. Name a reason why a man might not recognize his high school sweetheart at the 25th year reunion.
She done got ugly.
She done got ugly. That's when you have taken ugliness to a whole nother place. More specific than got ugly. About shot.
Hair fell out.
Whoa.
Hair fell out. Hair fell out. Hey, Joyce, you got no strikes, you're rolling. Tell me something about her man that a woman just might pretend to like.
His mama.
Oh. Good answer, good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Miss Joyce?
Yes, ma'am.
You kind of said that with a little... had a little something on that answer there.
I love my mother-in-law. I love her. I love you, mother-in-law.
That ain't the way it sounds. That ain't the way it sounds. His mama. That ain't have love on it at all.
I plead the
said something about your cooking one time, didn't you?
Never. You can't be this close up on me.
I know. Don't worry about that, girl. Don't let that bother you. You hear what she told me? She said, Steve, you can't be this close up on me. Watch yourself, Joyce. Yeah. Watch yourself. His mama. Name a job that's dirty, but someone has to do it.
A plumber.
Try again.
Of course. Dirty. Gynecologist.
You married, Rocco?
Not yet. Couple months.
Yeah, I better check with her after this one. Yeah. Boy, your buddy's at work when this goes on TV. It's about the best answer I've ever heard. You stunned the world with that one right there.
Sorry. I don't know
if we're gonna have enough tape to show the whole thing, but pretty sure they do on YouTube. You, my man, are gonna be so famous after this. You said that. I can't even repeat it. Survey said. Tracy, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
You're Ron's wife.
And his mom.
And his mom, Braden.
But I got confidence. He's gonna make that money in comic books.
That's what it is, comic book writing.
That's it.
You're pulling for it.
I'm pulling. So he's got passion, but you
just started buying into it, though.
You have to support him. You have to support him. Even if you're going, please, Lord.
I know. I tell you, my 14-year-old just came in the house and told me, Dad, I finally figured out what I want to be. He said, I want to be a WWF wrestler.
Oh. Yeah. And what'd you say?
Go in there and sit your stupid down.
What do you think it?
No, I ain't thinking nothing. All right, Tracy. Eskimos rub noses. What other body part might lovers rub together to signify a kiss?
This may be a kiss of another kind, but I'm going to say their private parts.
You said you're sorry, Ron. Yeah, I like what you did, Ron. I said, well, ain't no need of me messing around. I tell you what, it's what I'm gonna do. Yeah. This might be a kiss of another kind. I tell you what, if you get them two private parts scraping up against one another, that's about as kissy-kiss as you gonna get. Yeah. rubbing your private parts together a la Big Ronnie Skelton style. Name something that makes you grumpy if you don't get enough of it.
It's gotta be sex.
Yeah! Yeah. Yeah. Sex! Hey.
Yeah. Gotta have it. I don't really know what's wrong with me. 54 years old, you'd think I'd know how to behave a little better than this. But we ask 100 men, name a place on your body that a doctor might look in with a little flashlight.
But.
It's all right.
April? I'm 54 years old. I've been to the doctor so many times, but I can assure you, if that man ever takes a flashlight and shines it, me and that man right there, we're gonna tear that whole office up. Survey said, I hope my doctor's watching this. You break out a flashlight, see what happens, huh? We ask 100 men, name a place on your body that a doctor might look in with a little flashlight.
But.
Hi, Jasmine.
Hi, Steve.
You married?
I'm not. I'm single.
Single?
Yes.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, no kids.
No kids? Wow.
Wow. Hi, America.
What's some of the qualities you look for in a guy?
Honesty.
All right, I'm killing. And let me ask you something. Where are you folks from?
We're from Nashua, New Hampshire.
Nashua, New Hampshire. What do you do for a living, Ann?
I'm a dentist.
You're a dentist?
Yes, sir.
Because she learned from her father.
Uh-oh. Well, now. My man, what you say, baby? And let me tell you something. You must be one of the greatest dentists of all time. Emil, with that jacket on, and that tie, come out here, Emil. I got to get a pair of these. Emil, I got to get this. Emil.
Yes, sir.
You are my goal. I want to be 80, clear mind, sharp dresser. I want to be cussing everything.
But you said, you know, you got rid of all this flashy colors because you want to be more professional now.
Yeah, I did say that.
But in my case, I want to be younger even though I'm older.
Yes! So guess what I'm going to do? As I get older, I'm bringing back all my pimp clothes. Hey, Corey. Name something a husband starts doing differently. It makes his wife suspect he's cheating.
He's differently in bed, Steve.
Wow.
He's different in bed.
Different in bed. And all of a sudden, he got one leg up. You never saw that before.
Right, exactly.
So why is his leg up like that?
Where'd he learn that? Where'd he learn that?
That's what we're talking about.
I didn't teach him that.
You didn't teach him that. Well, gotta get it from somewhere. Let's go. As a last request, name something a stripper might want to be buried wearing. Corey.
Lingerie.
Lingerie. Emma.
G-string.
My man. G-string.
Let's go. Mambo. Mambo. Gotta get that cheese playing, baby. Yeah, baby. I love that. Y'all didn't know. And y'all sitting there going, what's he gonna say? The number one answer, baby.
Name something that follows the word pork.
You pine.
Huh?
This is the greatest answer I've ever heard.
You have a small.
Name something people bury in the backyard.
Placenta. You know, so that they get the rose bushes and stuff. I seen it on movies. They get the rose bushes.
Where y'all from?
What you taking baby dolls out in the backyard and burying placenta? How the hell do you come from the hospital with your placenta in a bag and take it out in the backyard because you want some roses? You ain't seen that on no movie. I ain't never heard of nothing so country in my life. I can't believe y'all said this on TV.
Name something that comes in 6-inch and 12-inch sizes.
Condoms. I can't believe I just said that.
Tell me a part of the body that begins with the letter T.
Titties.
Favorite part. Favorite part.
Without hesitation, and he saw absolutely nothing wrong.
Nope. Everybody's thinking it.
Name something you've never had, but you know you want it. Jimmy.
Menage a trois.
Wow, this is a good one. You didn't hear it, but I did. That was real good. Boy, say it in the mic, Jimmy.
Two women.
Not me.
Well, he said at the beginning, he said, menage a trois. But look at your mother-in-law, though. That's the look. She's looking like this. He said, she don't even know what that is. Name something you've never had, but you know you want it.
A bigger package.
Miss Belvia, how you doing today?
I'm fine, darling.
Good, good, yes. Good. You have anything to do with this answer?
Well, he ain't never had this answer, so, you know, yeah. I did. I'm so sorry.
I don't.
I'm not.
I know. No, you're trying to win this game.
I am.
You go to church, don't you?
Yes, I might have changed churches.
Jimmy, good job, Daddy. You guys actually played pretty well, man.
Thank you.
You wanna raise your hand up a little bit for me, Jimmy?
Yes, a little bit.
Thank you.
Oh,
my goodness.
All right, let's go. Miss Pam, give me something a man puts on that he thinks drives women wild.
A Steve Harvey suit and tie.
Name something that shakes when it's turned on.
A vibrator. I hope the kids at school aren't watching this.
Oh, they watching. It's elementary school, though. You're going to have to answer a lot of questions when you get back.
Sorry.
Just tell them it's a...
They're used to it. They're used to it with me, trust me. I mean, I don't talk like that in school, but never mind. I'm just digging myself deeper.
Yeah, yeah. This ain't looking good for the substitute teacher right now.
The calls are gonna stop coming.
Yeah, they are. Well, let's see how bad it is. Shannon, yes. Give me a title of a reality show that best describes your love life.
Well, my husband might not like me for this either, but I'm gonna say Fear Factor.
Wow.
I am happily married.
You were.
You thought you were.
Wow, do they hammer you like that all the time? Name something you've made love on top of. Shannon?
The hood of a car, baby.
The hood of a car. Mindy, tell me something that a fireman might be holding in a hot men of the fire department calendar. Come on, give it to me, Mindy. I know it. Go ahead.
His penis. Good answer.
He might be holding it in the calendar, like, you know. I'm thinking.
Show me one more time how he's standing, Mindy.
Like, maybe he'd be like, you know.
That's amazing. Hey, Cheryl, how you doing from Indiana?
How are you?
Good. What do you do there?
Well, I'm a registered nurse, but the biggest thing going on in my life right now is, and I haven't told my mother this, next week I'm getting my puppies fixed.
What's Greg standing over there grinning for?
Because I'm going to win the fast money and pay for the puppies.
Name a tool that reminds you of your husband in bed. Ron.
Hammer.
Big boy hammer. My man. Brittany, how you doing today?
I'm doing great. How about you?
Good, good. What do you do for a living again?
By day, I am a consultant at a healthcare company.
Uh-huh.
By night, I extreme coupon.
You do what?
Extreme coupon.
What's the most you've ever done? You've gotten to the counter, it cost how much and you paid what?
It cost $52 and I paid 16 cents.
What stupid store does this?
I'm not gonna say because I'm afraid they're watching.
Just a funny little thief, ain't you? I ain't gonna say because I'm afraid they're watching. Is there something that you specialize like in a certain food?
Frozen vegetables.
Frozen vegetables. Just go down there and wear them out on them frozen vegetables.
Come home with 50 bags of corn, you don't gotta buy any vegetables for a year.
You done had to eat 50 bags of corn, huh? Hang in there, man. Saving a lot of money, but she sure ain't creative as a cook. What are we having this morning? Corn. What do you think we're having? What are we having this afternoon? Corn cakes. What are we having for dinner? Corn pie. What's for breakfast? Corn flakes. Just shut up and eat it. We talked to 100 women. Name a tool that reminds you of your husband in bed.
Wrench.
All right. She might not be creative in the kitchen. But you smiling pretty good right now, though. We're doing it rich. Cheryl. Okay. Now you want to tell everybody what's going to happen next week?
I'm getting new puppy. True story.
Never called him a puppy before.
The twins are back.
The twins are back.
That's what I'm calling
They're coming
them.
Back big,
That's
huh?
Right.
And your husband Greg's grinning harder than you.
I like puppies, Steve.
You like puppies?
I like puppies.
See, right now you got. But after next week, you go. Mama, how you?
Oh my God, yes. Oh my God, I've been wanting to do this so bad. Oh my God. You like it? You like it, baby? You can scratch too. I watch you all the time. Every day. I do not miss you at all. And I go, oh my God, here he comes.
You gotta let him go.
appreciate it.
So, because I tell you, I really do, Steve. I love you to death.
Well, Miss Norma, I love you.
Oh, really?
Girl, so I got to tell you, matter of fact, I don't think I've ever been loved this much before.
Oh, God. Yeah, Lord, I could just go on and on and just love you. I'm rubbing your back. I'm getting them muscles.
We got to be quiet. Come on. Yeah. Yeah. Mama, we got to pray.
She was telling me to let you go.
Mama, what would you do if you found out your man once acted in an X-rated movie?
I'd probably leave him for a while.
You'd probably leave him for a while?
Yeah.
Just a little while.
Just a little while. But then pull himself out.
Let him pull himself out.
Right. All right, Mom. Then I'd be ready for him when he got home.
That's a good answer.
Please take this answer. I don't care. Whispering things to me you can't hear. I'm scared.
Don't be scared. Don't be scared, Steve. Don't be scared.
Okay, I'm trying. All right. You ready, Miss Normal?
I'd leave him, like I said. Not then be somebody else.
And you find you somebody else.
You better believe
she find herself somebody else. How about that? Name a place a woman might call heaven on earth. Number six. Let's move on to question two. Give me Jeanette. Give me Bernice. Name, I still got the same. I had the same thing. Name a place a woman might call heaven on earth. The coochie. Kawana.
That's it?
See how I got it?
Yeah, you got it.
I broke it on down. See, I specialize in African-American names.
All right. Pronounce it.
I have a lot of African-American family members.
You do?
We have names like that. Very unique. For those of you that's not African American, don't try that. Just call her Coco. Because old black people can't say that. Where's Coco? We talked to 100 women. Name something most women wouldn't be caught dead leaving the house without.
Their vibrator.
Well, on my way to the grocery store, where in the world is my toy? Ain't no telling how long these lines gonna be.
I love to sing.
Are you serious?
I am, very serious. At church, school, wherever I've been, I've always sung.
Let me hear a little bit of it.
I'll be your crying shoulder. I'll be love suicide.
If dogs use computers, what would they post pictures of on the internet? Terrell.
The girlfriend cat, a cat.
The girlfriend cat. That's amazing how you thought of that.
You don't play.
Name an animal sound that would not be sexy coming from your husband in bed.
Moo!
do that again.
Moo!
Did y'all ever did that before? Never did moo.
Big John.
Maybe a roar. Woo. Big John.
I got a moo.
Yeah! Name an animal sound that would not be sexy coming from your husband in bed.
A horse. Neigh.
A horse. Do it again.
Neigh.
Meow.
You know, the boys down at the Rock Quarry, you know, already know. You know they're going to eat you alive.
I know they will.
And just to make sure, you got to do it one more time.
Oh, Lord, you're killing me, Steve.
I know, John. Go ahead one more time.
Meow.
I talked to 100 married women. Give me an animal sound that would not be sexy coming from your husband in bed.
Cricket.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's going to be way better than that cat one, boy. What did you just say?
You know what? It's no. Like nothing's going on, you know?
Name something that gets up in the morning before you do.
Sorry, Mom, but for men, they're penis.
At what age does a man no longer have the strength to fool around? You said 35. Survey said, number one answer, 100.
Oh, 100. Wow. I love that one.
Shut up. It's the truth. Tell me something people pick out ahead of time so the funeral will be fabulous.
I would have to say food.
Will you walk in the door and just grab a sandwich? How old are you, man?
I'm 25.
25? Boy, yes, you look young. Hey! You're only 25, you don't know nothing about this. Name the worst place to be when the Viagra you took kicks in.
I would say at school.
Good answer! Yes! Good answer! Yeah!
Good answer!
At school. With the rest of the kids. I mean, look, you got to know. Guy's 25. He has no idea. I know all of these. Hell, when you're hosting a game show. I said, name a part of your body. The doctor checks during a routine physical exam. You said, your breast. Survey said.
A woman answer.
Yeah, I know. I think you might want to report your doctor. Name's.
You're right.
It's only happened to three other people. That's not good. It's not routine at all. Name a part of your body the doctor checks doing a routine physical exam.
Your junk, your privates.
Okay, hold on. <time out. laughs> You sure need to find out who the hell y'all doctor is, though. Your junk. Survey said. Hey, Crystal. How you doing, dog?
I'm doing great.
Good.
Hey, let me say this, Steve. I knew you were fine, but you're even finer in person.
Be careful, Crystal. This is not a game. Good.
What do you do for a living, Crystal?
Well, I'm a dental assistant. I work in Douglasville at Creekside Dental.
Yep, you got pretty white teeth, too.
Yeah.
She said, just Creekside like Dental. And then flashed that commercial out.
Are you looking for a dental practice that puts your needs first?
at Creekside Dental.
One more time, right in that camera. Where you work, right there, say it.
Creekside Dental.
Creekside Dental.
I got it.
I go there too. Name some information you wouldn't want to be the last one at the office to know about.
You were caught stealing?
Come on.
You wouldn't want to be the last one at the job to know you got caught stealing.
Yes,
if you was down there stealing, Kim, wouldn't you already have that information? I'm just checking, Kim. Listen to me, girl. Every time I stole, I knew I was stealing. When they caught me, I tried to act surprised.
Ooh, what? Oh, what?
That wasn't me?
Name some information you wouldn't want to be the last one at the office to know about.
There's a layoff.
There is a layoff. Listen to me. Let's get this straight. Let me talk to your Carlisle family right now. See these answers up here? Your objective, once you see one, is to guess the one that ain't turned over yet. We don't need y'all reading what's on the board. Most of these people have an education. Sometimes you gotta go over the rules again. Okay, you got it, son?
I got it.
Here we go. Name some information you wouldn't want to be the last one to know at the office know about.
That the building's on fire?
That the building
is on
fire.
Good answer. Good answer. All right.
Sure, I can almost guarantee you that ain't up there. I'm sitting here typing. Ain't nobody told me nothing. Now I got all these third degree burns on my butt, and y'all sitting up here running down the hallway and ain't saying nothing to me. How did I know what that smell was? But baby, your dress was on fire. How did I supposed to know? Name something bad you did as a kid you're still afraid to tell your parents about. Kim.
Still.
Still. Kind of running theme we got here. All that stealing finally paid off.
Yay! Huh?
Who'd ever knew that would turn out to be the number one answer in America? A wife can really cut her husband down to size by making fun of his what?
I'm gonna say his manhood.
Megan, I don't know what you mean by that. Well, let's go see his manhood. Hey, all you women that's out there clapping, listen to me. Don't call your man Shrinky Dink, okay? You'll wind up in a real situation, I can tell you that right now. You can do a lot of stuff, but what I ain't about to be is Shrinky Dink.
Okay.
Let's go, man. A wife can really cut her husband down to size by making fun of his what?
I have to go hike.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Kevin, let me ask you something, man. Kind of had to deal with that a little bit.
Pretty much, sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes it's good, though.
That's right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good thing come in small package.
Yes, sir.
Shrinky dinky.
Hey, Lincoln?
Yeah,
I do the jokes on this show. Here. Tell me something you might rent for an hour.
I wouldn't do it, but motel.
Peppy, you wouldn't do it. How do you know about it?
Friends?
Friends? Peppy.
Yeah! I'm thinking of tuxedo. Tuxedo.
Let me ask you a question, Lee. Mm-hmm. Put this tux on 1 hour. Where you going?
Just somewhere for about 30 to 40 minutes.
30 to 40 minutes? Just go down there, just want to pop in.
I might go to the motel. I might take it to the motel for now.
Lincoln, let me tell you something.
Okay.
You've been telling some good jokes.
Yeah.
Ain't now one of your answers been up there. Okay. And let's just go and stay hugged up
all
like
right,
this.
All right.
Because I got a feeling that ain't up there either.
What's up, Christy?
There we go. That tuxedo. I love this guy right here. All right, we got one strike, Simone.
A prostitute.
Okay. Okay. That's a good answer.
A prostitute. Priya.
Yes.
Tell me something you might rent for an hour.
A hall to have a party.
Oh, a hall to have a party.
Yes.
All right, everybody, let's go. Everybody, get something to eat. Eat it, hurry up. Eat it. Eat it. Mr. John?
Yes, sir.
Nice to talk to you. What do you do for a living, sir?
Watch the Family Feud.
That's all you do?
That's how we got
sit there and watch
that's
Family
all
Feud.
I got
well,
to
how
do.
You like it now, though?
I love it.
Boy, yeah. Something else, ain't
I love it.
That little host they got.
Out of sight. That's one reason I look at it.
Is it?
That's it.
Boy, I ain't gonna lie to you. Name something a man would be holding that a woman might find sexy.
His private.
Good answer, Bob! Good answer. Good answer, Bob! Good answer. Woo! Now, when this air pump went on, how do you think people down that church gonna feel about that?
Probably not too good, probably. That kept me married for 50 years.
The baloney pony. Name a place where someone greets people as they enter. Cassie.
Walmart.
Walmart.
Why was that it?
No, really. No, you got it in time.
Whoa.
Walmart. Cassie, pass a plate.
They
go play. Cassie bounced right on over here.
Yes, she did.
Hey, Bob.
How you doing?
How you doing, sir?
I'm doing great.
Good, good, good. What do you do for a living?
Well, I'm retired. I play a lot of golf, and I just recently celebrated my 49th wedding anniversary.
Wow. That's pretty good, man.
That's not easy. You got to treat her respect, take her on great trips. For our 25th, I took her to China, and next year I'm going to go pick her up.
Be sitting around writing these jokes, man. Name something that follows the word pork.
You pine.
Huh?
Huh? You pine. Pork
good
you pine.
Answer! Good answer! Good answer! Yes! That's my tank! Yes! Lunatic!
Pork. He said, Q-pine. Q-pine. What? What is Q-pine? This is the greatest answer I've ever heard.
No, I feel you.
It's number one.
Oh, my mama.
Pow. It's number one. Oh, really? Well, I tell you what. She's gonna be number one on YouTube, but.
Cupid!
Name a part of your body that sees the least sun.
Your private parts.
Your private parts.
Yes!
What is a cooter? Name an occupation where you see people swinging something. Pumpkin?
Boxing! Boxing!
Boxing!
Boxing!
Pastor, I'm doing pretty good with you and the fellas.
I'm not hurt.
Well, I've trying, been trying.
You, I know you've been trying.
Been trying. But you, who is she, your cousin?
No, my sister.
That's your sister-in-law? Yeah, she just hit me in the back.
She hit you?
Yeah, that kind of threw me off a little bit.
You're not going to file charges or
nothing,
right?
No, I'm going to file charges, but I think they tell you in rehearsal, don't put your hands on the host.
I
think they do. We're going to put that in the rehearsal.
I'm going to talk.
Keep your hands off the host. And she pushed me kind of hard. You know,
no, she didn't.
Punkin' treat me a little rough right now. We're going ahead and wheel, though.
Okay. All
right,
sir. We're sorry.
That's okay. Thank you.
We're sorry, Steve.
Name something a policeman might do to a suspect that he shouldn't do to a woman on their first date. Heidi.
Tase him.
So you don't want to kiss, huh? Really? How are you doing today, darling?
Good, how are you?
Hey, if your mate is loud in the bedroom, what might you do so the neighbors don't hear?
Put a pillow over their head.
That's true. That's a good answer. That's a good answer. Yes, put me up there.
Catherine, wow. I mean, just looking at you, I'm not thinking.
You never know.
Yeah. Yeah, take it easy, buddy. Take it easy, boy. I got you, yeah. Hey, Brandon, tell me something that a bride wants to be huge.
Her man.
Her man.
That's good answer.
Excellent. Yeah. Brandon, they need you to be, they want to know, what do you mean by her man?
The dong.
Huh?
The whopper.
Say what now?
Penis?
I thought. Brandon, you know, Brandon, see, I got to teach, the art of comedy is this. You were on such a roll, you said the dong, the whopper. I thought you'd just stay right there. You know, with, you know, names that, you know, the bazooka, you know, the hammer, you know, the cute stuff like that. That's all you had to do. Just stay right there. Just let the joke sell itself. Oh, no, you want to end the joke. Oh, joke over. Let's stop laughing right now. Your penis. Everybody went, oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Did he have to say that? Yes, he did. The dong. Yeah! What do you do for a living, Ron?
I cremate bodies. Don't worry, I can work whenever I want to. They're not in any hurry.
Ron, how long you been, I don't know how to put this in all the way. How long you been setting people on fire?
Well, I own the crematory. But I learned about that business because my wife and I have a pizza oven in the backyard. Wood fired.
That's where you first tried somebody?
No. We did neighborhood cats and dogs.
Hey, Ron, I'm tell you something. I'm tell you something, Ron. I don't really care to talk to you no more. Chris, that's your wife down there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Where your ring at, Chris?
At home, Steve.
At home. Okay. Yeah, if you think that's a good answer. Do you know it was at home, Joy?
Well, actually, he lost it on the golf course. He's not telling the truth right now. He lost both of them.
He lost both
of
them.
He lost, and after the second one, I said, no more.
I like to take my wedding ring off, and I have left my wedding ring on a golf cart before.
I understand.
Fortunately, went back and get, that don't mean nothing to you,
though,
does it?
It does not mean anything.
Okay, let's just, okay. Name something Tarzan may take off his loincloth to do. Dana.
Have sex.
Have sex. Two answers topic, James.
To swing better in the trees.
To swing. James, you think that cloth been getting hung up? Swing it by in a tree. Derek, how you doing, sir? You married?
I am married, been married for 15 years. My wife, Stacy, we have two children. Eli, he's 9. Emily is 5. And
well,
she's going to be a star, too.
Might as well put you under the bus, too.
Uh-oh. Let me, well, hold on, wait a minute.
Where's that red ring, Derek?
Well, I lost mine, too.
Hey, quit. Show him your hand. He's married. He lost his ring, too. Can you believe this? Look at Joy. Joy going, uh-uh. Mm-mm. Turn around and do your little answers. You ain't got nothing to do with over here. How long ago you lose it, man?
It's probably been 10, 11 years ago. My wife told me.
Been about 10, 11 years ago. I lost that problem. I've been looking for it the whole time. Yeah. Based on his personality, what kind of bug would you compare your husband to? Tasha.
A roach.
Tasha, when you say not him, but the question clearly was your husband. Miles, how you doing, man?
I'm doing great, Steve. How about you?
How old are you, Miles?
I'm 20 years old.
You ready to go?
Yes, sir.
All right, Miles, tell me a place where you saw the opposite sex naked for the first time. You probably haven't, but don't worry about it.
Strip club.
Good answer. That's a good answer, though.
Strip club. How you doing?
Great, thank you.
Theater major?
Yes.
Very pretty. How old are you?
I'm 16.
16?
Yes.
16, Steve.
You got problems, partner. You're going to have to hurt somebody. Man, all right, I'm going to have to go down here. We're going to do this a little bit different. Read this question for Kayla.
Sure. Kayla. Tell me a place where you saw the opposite sex naked for the first time.
Okay. Not me personally, but the internet.
Oh, yeah, good answer.
No, that's not a good answer. Because it's true. You're looking at the naked people on the internet. That's it. Your computer's gone. When a husband and wife have an argument, what usually happens at the end of their argument? Oliver.
The gentleman ends up being scolded again.
The gentleman ends up being scolded again. When a husband and wife have an argument, what usually happens at the end of the argument?
The husband says, I'm sorry.
Yes, yes, yes! Yes!
24 years, 24
Always.
Years.
Always. That's you right. Just say I'm sorry.
Me.
She can be dead wrong. You have to say you're sorry.
I'm sorry, Steve.
I know you do. I do it all the time.
Oh, I thought you wanted to
no,
say okay.
No. I do it all the time.
Yes, sir.
Because if we don't say I'm sorry, it continues.
because they can argue all night long.
And so on and so on and so
That's
on.
That's the same as number one. Oh, no, it's not. They need another one. They say okay. That's the same thing.
I get a good one.
I want you to know something.
Yes, sir.
That's the best answer I've heard today.
Thank you. Thank you.
And don't ever get off of that.
That's right.
Don't let these judges on Family Feud ruin your marriage.
Now, hey, we've been together 24 years, met at Rutgers University, still going strong.
That's right.
My man. Yeah. Miles, there's no way you know anything about this.
I've been alive for 20 years. I've seen my parents argue over and over and over. So I think I'm used to it.
Shut up! Shut up!
Not what you say on TV about your parents. I've been lying 20 years. I've heard all and all and over. I'd have said to myself, oh, Lord, when this going to ever stop? Okay, Miles, when a husband and wife have an argument, what usually happens at the end of their argument?
They watch a romantic movie.
Okay.
You seen that at the house?
Not yet.
I tried to give him an out. I said, you seen that at the house? Not yet. This kid is killing this man.
Hey, Steve.
Hey, Mary.
How you doing?
Hey. So what do you do for a living?
Nothing.
Yeah.
Actually, I am retired, and I am what would be considered a cougar motorcycle babe.
A cougar motorcycle. Okay, you ride motorcycles.
On the back.
Oh, just on the back.
Yeah, but that's
oh,
still...
but you're on the back of young boys' bike.
Yeah. Not boys, not plural. Just one.
Just one.
My special one.
Oh,
hey,
your
sweetie.
Special one. Oh, well.
All right, turn that off.
Hell, this thing got good here. We got a cougar motorcycle, babe, and it's just one. You a cougar. How old is he?
He's 11 years younger than I am.
Well, got your hair. Yep, that's why you got your hair right and all that. Right now, just keeping it going. That's what can happen. See, you're going to get your one if you keep yourself together, see? On the back of the motorcycle. So when y'all getting married?
Oh, no.
I'm not gonna marry the baby. I'm just playing with the baby. Anyway.
Well, we've both been there, so.
I'm retired. I ain't splitting my check with nobody. I ride you on your motorcycle, but you got to go home.
But I came here to win money so I can buy my own motorcycle.
All right.
Oh, and then you ain't riding on the back. He gonna be out then.
No. He's wow. Too special to be out.
Oh, ooh, you something else.
Yes,
you
I just, am.
She said, yes, I am. You're a firecracker. Go on the back of that motorcycle. Come on, let's go.
Let's go, baby.
Yeah, I'll help you stop it. Come on, faster. What you doing? I'm back here. Go ahead, too slow.
That's right.
Give me a slang term that people use for marijuana.
Dime bag.
Yeah. I've heard it.
I love it.
I don't know what it means.
Shut up, Jeff. Just shut up.
I swear.
In order for you to even say dime bag, you have to be a user.
I swear.
I know you swear, but I don't know how. You done broke it down. Let me ask you a question. What is a dime bag, Jeff?
I have no idea.
Yes, you
no,
do.
I don't. I swear. I don't know.
What do you think it means, Jeff?
It's a Ziploc bag with marijuana in it.
How much? How much?
$10.
Thank you, sir. Name something your husband says you're really bad at. We talked to 100 married women.
Sex.
My church,
Yeah, she don't go to your church. She ain't got no husband. Because there ain't a husband on planet Earth gonna ever turn to his wife and go, you're really not good at sex. That is a suicidal statement. You say that, you're the dumbest guy on planet Earth. Hey, Elizabeth, how are you?
Hi, I'm doing great.
Good.
How
what do you,
you
do for a living?
I am a self-employed nanny. I watch babies.
Good. That's good. That's
lots
good.
Of different babies.
And you're married?
I'm newly engaged as of Friday.
Newly engaged? Oh, Elizabeth, you did it.
You gotta get the money.
Yeah, gotta yeah. get it. Who is it?
Who is my fiance? His name's Elijah. He's a ginger.
He's a what?
He's a ginger with the red hair.
Never heard
Some
of that.
Them are kind of weird looking. He's a good one.
He's a good looking yeah. ginger. Is that right? I don't know if that's borderline racism if I say ginger, so.
No, it's not.
Yeah. We gonna edit that out the show. I don't know what ginger is. I don't think I need to say it though. I'm gonna leave it alone. I like redhead people and freckles and all that. So just gonna leave it at that. That's gingerbread man.
He actually dressed up as a gingerbread man for Halloween, and he just took cardboard and cut out a bread slice and put it on both sides of him and
this
wore his
is
normal
crazy.
Clothes.
This is I'm actually having an out-of-body experience right now. Name something a woman might train her dog to find out about a man by sniffing him.
The woman and the dog want to know if he's gay, Steve. If he's gay.
I don't want to say that. I have a career.
I don't, Steve.
I know. She's trained the dog to sniff the man to find out if he's gay. What do you do in the restroom when there's no toilet paper?
Shake.
Off in the sink. How'd you like to walk in a public toilet and see somebody with their ass hanging in the sink? I'm sorry. They were out of toilet paper. Had to wash it off in the sink. Name an occupation where someone wears a robe at work. Aaron.
What is a surgeon?
You thought we were playing Jeopardy?
For a second. Just for a second.
What is a surgeon? Hey, Mitchell.
Yes.
No problem here. We talked to 100 men. One of them could have been you. Name a food you like to see a sexy woman eating. You're standing next to one.
I want to see her eating a popsicle.
Well, she didn't like that answer, but don't worry about it. You got a dozen at the house right now, don't you? Milton, how you doing?
I am doing well, Steve. How about yourself?
Good, good. Got a victory under your belt yesterday.
It feels good.
Good,
feels good.
Good. Yeah, you're the dentist, right?
Yes, sir.
The
yes,
smiling sir. Dentist. This dude I'm just grins the whole day. It's good to see you got nice teeth. You're single?
I'm single, and I'm ready to mingle.
You want somebody in the Dallas area?
I don't mind. Studio audience, Dallas, it doesn't matter.
I don't care where she is. Over there, anywhere.
Huckleberry, I'm okay.
He
I'm
said,
okay.
Huckleberry, I'm okay. I'm good. Hey, Corey, how you doing,
what's up,
man?
Sir? How you doing, man?
Yeah, let me tighten that up for you. What do you do for a living, Corey?
Hey, man, I'm a middle school educator, and I'm a basketball coach, head basketball
My
coach.
My man. That's
My man.
Like,
My
what?
Man. Yes, sir.
Man, hey, that's what somebody and, asked me one time if I could do anything other than what I do, what would I like to do? I'd like to be a basketball coach.
I was born in Wyandotte, Georgia.
You were born in Wyandotte?
Born.
He's sitting there, but where he from?
West Virginia.
West Virginia.
West Virginia.
Well, West Virginia. You know a little bit about that. You know a little bit about that.
Wait a minute, hold on,
you know a little bit about that, Z.
You from where, man?
Welch, West Virginia.
Dog, I was born in Welch, West Virginia.
No way.
Well, my dad and grandfather all worked in the mines.
Well, everybody did. My daddy made $5 a week.
Wow.
Yeah. We had five kids. My daddy made $5 a week. We grew everything we ate in the backyard.
Yes, sir.
Can I hug you, man?
No doubt. What I'm talking about, man. Damn.
Name a place a woman goes where it might be inappropriate to wear a push-up bra.
I'm gonna go with the funeral.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Sure am gonna miss you. Dogs go crazy when they see a squirrel. What do men go crazy about when they see it? Samantha.
Nuts.
Men go crazy when they see nuts. Name a fantasy job you'd want if you lived during the Old West.
Saloon showgirl.
Yeah.
Who nice. Wants to be the saloon showgirl? That's a good answer.
How hard it was to say that?
He said, you know how hard it was to say that? Name a fantasy job that you'd want if you lived during the Old West.
How about a blacksmith?
Yeah, good answer. Good answer. Very good answer.
Next time, Linda, kind of push it together a little faster just for me, okay? How about a black... Hey, whoa, lady. Whoa. Where we going with this now? Sorry, just a little touchy sometimes. How about a black smith? I was hanging on that black way too long. Name a fantasy job you'd want if you lived during the Old West.
Prostitute.
This guy here, prostitute. Hey, Ken, what's going on, boy? I like Stan.
That is a Steve Harvey original.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Boy, look at you right there. That's right. That's a Steve Harvey suit. And I like that.
It feels good.
Ken, is this...
My wife, Debbie.
Your wife, Debbie? Debbie?
She was my third and favorite wife.
She's your third and favorite wife.
That's correct.
I know exactly what you mean.
Thank you.
Man.
Thank you, sir.
I thank you for saying it, man. I'm glad. Oh, we're going to have to get us a club. William, one strike. Tell me something a man has that he likes to polish.
His man part. Yeah, that's good. I mean, not that I know from experience or anything.
Shut up. Hi, Trelane.
It's a character from Star Trek.
Your mama named you?
A character from Star Trek, yes. It was an alien guest star.
an alien guest
yes.
star. So
mm-hmm.
he didn't even make it on
he
the
was
show.
Not on the actual
Your
show.
Mom was sitting up there. This happened in. She was pregnant with you when it happened. Right. She's sitting up there eating some ice cream and a pickle. That's the prettiest damn name I ever heard right there. Trey Lane. Name something a circus clown might take off his rubber nose to do. Number seven. The clown? Mama, the clown is high! Jeff, what do you do, man?
I'm an emergency room physician.
Are you?
How long have you guys been married?
7 years.
7 years.
6 years. Almost 7 years.
Jeff.
Right? Is that
Jeff.
Right?
Jeff!
Sorry.
You don't turn around and ask her. Are you stupid? Kurt,
hey.
What's going on, partner?
How we doing?
Good. You married, Kurt?
I am not. Single.
Well, you said that. I am not.
No.
Nor do I want to be. Next question, please. Are you dating anybody serious?
Not right now, Steve. You got anyone in mind for me?
Hey, I mean, Kurt, you know, you're on TV, you might want to be a little careful here, because if you're dating a girl that thinks it's serious, and I just said, are you dating somebody seriously? And you said, not right now. It's gonna blow the wig back. So you want to try that question again? Are you dating anybody seriously?
Yes, and she is great. Oh, she is the best. Love her to death.
I'll tell you, man, I know how to take care of a guy. Name something a wife hates to discover her new husband does in his sleep.
Masturbate.
Good answer!
Good answer! Hypothetically speaking, of course.
Name something you would never do again if your wife didn't force you to. Kyle.
Get married.
I did not force him to get married.
It's okay, Carla. It's okay. I know you didn't force him, baby.
I did not force him.
I know you didn't force him. I know you didn't
Oh, my God.
You can't believe how stupid you are.
Yeah, I'm going to get that.
And what's going to be even more stunning, watch this. Admit it. Name something of your wife's you tried on when she wasn't around.
Underwear.
Yeah!
Wow.
Underwear. Elise?
High heels.
High heels.
Wow.
High heels. What man has a wife and he can wear her shoe? That's a 13, folks. If I slip that into my wife's shoe, we're getting a divorce. No, my wife's foot can't be this same size. There's no way we can be laying in bed and the covers come up and her foot look like my foot.
Can you give me a beat?
All right,
can I give you a beat? Name something Shaquille O'Neal has that's bigger than yours.
I'm gonna go with hands.
He's got, well, that's a body part. That's a body
part.
I'm
gonna go with junk.
Good answer, good answer, good answer.
That's all body parts? I know you're the judge here, but I just got to, that's a totally separate item. That's handled differently, it's set aside differently, it's cared for, it's protected with our life. I actually have an alarm system. Whoop, 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 whoop! Warning, warning, you're too close. Back up. We ask 100 men, name a part of your body a blindfolded person might touch and think belong to a woman.
Their private parts.
Oh,
Steve, I'm a licensed massage therapist.
Watch
I've been
out, boy.
Rubbing bodies for 10 years.
Shut
baby.
Up.
Yes, sir.
Bless hands, baby. Yeah.
One of
you don't see no hard work here, do you?
Well, you ain't ever out of work.
Oh, no. I had to get permission from my wife first, though.
You're married?
Yes. She said, long as I bring it home. She don't mind.
All right, now.
There she is right there.
Yeah,
she's smiling. See her smiling?
Where she at? Yeah. Grinning and waving.
Hello, woman. Good.
Hi. Hi, Mr. Hands. Well, that's good, man. What is it that a customer likes most during a massage?
Well, my clients, they like them buns rubbed.
I can't believe, what? What the hell are you grinning that hard for? Most of my clients like them buns rubbed.
Yeah, that's it. Hey. Gluteus maximus is the best part, the biggest muscle in the body, baby.
Name a phrase that takes courage to say for the first time.
Well, Steve, this doesn't pertain to me because I'm celibate, but you have a small penis!
Looking at me?
Oh.
Don't pretend to me, Steve, but you have a small penis. Name something you toss.
Toss them draws.
Name something you hope doesn't fall apart while you're on it.
My wife.
Best answer I ever heard. Marie, how are you doing today?
Good, how are you?
What do you do?
Well, I investigate adult abuse and neglect with the state of Alabama.
And you're staring at me.
Are you being spanked now as an adult and you need protection?
I try to every now and then. Yeah. So just know this, though.
Okay.
When you spank me,
I don't think that's the kind of the spanking I protect.
Could I tell you something?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're going to do it anyway.
No, my little niece, Annie.
We're going to play the game after a while. Y'all hang in there.
It'll just be, it's like, is emotionally involved with you. Emotionally, not physically, emotionally involved with you.
Wait a minute,
she's red?
I don't know any of you. I've never met you before.
We haven't so, met her either.
I'm married, stop. Now, I'm in an extramarital affair that I don't even know about. That's the worst kind. I'm gonna get another divorce. At least I need to know who the hell is by.
She keeps your book in her car, and that's when
Oh, well, that's good. Just let Annie read the book.
Oh, yeah, Hal. Oh, you used to knock them dead, didn't you, boy? Oh, I could tell, pretty dude like you.
Freckles, sneaky looking.
Oh.
You got your little mustache and goatee with a drawing on it. Anytime a man cuts his goatee to make it look like a champagne glass, that's sexy right there. That's when you're sexy right there.
Yeah.
I bet nobody ever told you that, had it?
No, it has.
No.
My wife loved it.
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
She likes sipping on that champagne, huh? Oh, Deacon, you just up in there doing the most down there. Hey, name something a babysitter might be too busy doing to play with the kids.
when I knew this girl, she baby, I would go by and see her. So I would be over there and we'd be making out. And I'd be massaging her, Steve. That good enough for you?
Somewhere making love, too busy to play with the kid. Oh,
there we go.
My name fell off, Steve. Huh? My name fell off.
What the hell is going on over here? Hey, Samson, we only got one strike. Name something a babysitter might be too busy doing to play with the kids.
I'm a very responsible parent. Let me put that out there. But sometimes...
Let me ask y'all something. Let me ask something about this family right here. Can y'all ever just answer the question? And what you do for a living?
I am, I work at my mother's kitchen, which is a soul food place. I would just love to have you there, Steve.
Well, I'm coming to Chicago. What's the name of the restaurant?
My mother's kitchen, Comfort Southern
Food. You said you work.
Food. I work there. I'm a waitress.
Yeah. Okay, I was trying to get the name of your mama's restaurant.
My mother's kitchen.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Kitchen, honey, just help yourself. It's okay.
I heard you say it was your mama's kitchen. I'm trying to find out the name of the place.
It's my mother's kitchen, Southern okay. Comfort Foods.
You greet the people at the door?
Oh, I hug everybody come in there. I say, oh, welcome, darling, to my mother's kitchen.
Yeah, I am
so proud that you came to visit us.
Uh-huh.
Oh, they love it. They love it.
I know they do.
Yes, and they call me Sweet Dorothy at the restaurant. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
And you probably the reason y'all on the show, too,
Absolutely.
I know all of this here.
Lovely.
You have a holy name.
That's a holy name?
Holy. St. Stephen.
Do you know my whole name? Broderick Stephen Harvey. You know who I was named after?
No.
Broderick Crawford on Highway, the Highway Patrol show. Broderick Crawford. Name something a single guy might have a collection of from all the women he's dated.
Bruises?
That's true.
You can believe that.
I'm sure you got a scratch or two somewhere.
I got a scratch or two?
Sure.
Well, I mean, you know.
Play a player.
I got some scratches, but they was on my back.
Oh! Well.
You feel me? This is what I do for a living.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you can't stomp me. Watch out. Isabella, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good, good.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I would like to say a shout out to my husband who is in the audience, my husband of 37 years, Henry.
Henry here today?
Henry is here.
Let me see, where is Henry?
Yes, he is.
Henry. Yes, sir.
All right.
Didn't want Henry on the show?
Oh, yeah. He's here.
I said didn't want him on the show.
He's morals, he's good support.
Yeah, didn't want him on the show. Didn't want Henry out here trying to take a shot at this 20,000, huh? You picked the five people in your family you thought could win this money, huh? They said, how about Daddy? Don't worry, Daddy just come and support the show. I can't play no Family Feud. I've been working. I don't even know what the show about. Henry had a job all his life, ain't he?
He did.
So he ain't
retired
got time.
Military.
The whole family involved in the military?
Pretty much.
Well, that's good. Thank all y'all.
Yeah,
thank you. Come, Miss Isabella, let's go. Name something a man drops when a woman suddenly says she wants him.
His pants.
All right, bring on. Get right on up, James. I gotta tell you, you just hold on. That is the first thing, too. We don't take our shirt off, shoes, nothing. I want you. Okay. Get these puppies. They be down around our ankle, but Ashanti, name something a man drops when a woman suddenly says she wants him.
How about some money?
All right. Hey,
what Ashanti, what type of woman you think we're talking about here. Hi, how you doing? I want you. Oh, hell. Name something a woman does to make a man want to kiss her.
Takes her clothes off.
You gonna kiss me now? Huh? You gonna kiss me now, boy? Huh? Oh, yeah, mama sure do. Name something you do to your bottom.
After you get off that porcelain guard, you wipe it.
I suggest, John, that you try wiping it before you get off the porcelain guard. I don't know where y'all's role is at. But you need to move it a little closer to that toilet. I don't like teaching people how to wipe on this show, but when you hear a family come in and said, after I get up off the porcelain guard, I wipe it. No, no, no. You need to sit right there. Don't you move. That's how my little boy used to do. He used to get up and just walk. We'd have company over. I was potty training my son. He used to just get up and just walk in the living room. He just in there talking to people. Ain't got no drawers on. Flies buzzing around him. Well, Selena, how you doing today?
I just want to say, I really do love you. You are the first voice I hear when I get up.
You love the radio.
I love
it. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
I got a major behind me that's in charge of some missile command division. I kind of just want us to be clear about this
yes,
love.
The radio show.
The radio show, yeah. There
yes.
you go, Major Sergeant.
That's it.
Name something you do to your bottom.
You spank it.
Good answer.
Major. Damn. Yeah. Major Bennett in there handling business.
Shout out to my wife, my three kids, three beautiful kids, and my one lovely wife, Elizabeth. Been married 22 years, Steve.
There you go, Rob.
22 years, baby.
Make it happen, baby.
There you go, baby. There you go.
It's going good.
22 years.
All right, let's go. You ought to know this one then.
Oh, man, I know.
Name
I got
something
one for
that sports
you.
Teams do to players that husbands wish they could do to
man,
their wives.
Man, Steven, I do it every night. I tackle mine. Woo, baby. Come on. Up there. Yeah!
Tito, what's up, man?
So,
how you doing?
Good. What do you do, Tito?
I'm a barber in Elgin, Illinois.
Oh, man.
Westside Customs. Cuts.
Custom Deuces. Cuts is the
Custom
name
Custom Cuts.
Of... Yeah, how many chairs in there?
One. The captain's chair. That's right. What that there do? Y'all know me.
They know you?
They know me.
Hey, boy, so when this air... And it shows in the shop, you're gonna be king, baby.
That's right. I'm gonna be applauding myself.
You are ready to be king.
Name someone you wouldn't wanna know that you were dating a stripper.
Your friends.
Good answer.
Your friends. Kyla, them the first people I'm telling. Hey, fellas. You remember Bubblicious? All right, here we go. Name something made out of leather a wife might hit her husband with.
Her leather panties.
Go get yourself a pair of them leather panties. Oh. Keep your man at the house. Beat me with the leather panties. Rod. You're probably one of our most famous people. You know, with YouTube clips, his clip is one of the most watched YouTube clips in the history of Family Feud. Name something a burglar would not want to see when he breaks into a house. Rob.
Naked grandma!
Naked, huh?
Looking for a naked grandmama in the house. This is big. Welcome to Family Feud's Big Money Tournament finale. I'm your man, Steve Harvey, and boy, look a hill. We got a good one for you today. From Atlanta, Georgia, it's the Woolley family. And straight out of Gainesville, Florida, it's the Hutchinson family. We want to say thank you so much to Publishers Clearing House, because one of these families is going to win on this show right here, $160,000. There is no fast money today. The first family to reach 400 points will win the game and the entire jackpot of $160,000. Woolley family, man, it's thick. If it's there, your family steals, your family wins $160,000. Damon, name something you'd be more likely to see at a bachelor party than at a bridal shower.
Something I've been doing all day here is fighting, fighting, fighting.
This answer is worth $160,000 to someone. We are looking for fighting. Look at number four. Yeah, man. Woo! Hey, fellas, come over here. Yeah, man. Listen to me. These are friends at Publishers Clearing House, and they're presenting the Hutchinson with $160,000. Tell me something you put in your mouth, but you don't swallow.
Wow.
You ever walked up to somebody and saw the look on their face and you just know? When people talk about the big one, what might they be referring to?
You know, I'm gonna have to go with orgasm. Oh!
My mom's watching this. Well,
like, you're the one bursting out in
there.
Your mom's watching and your dad is what?
A pastor?
But hey, my dad's a pastor. That's how we got here. Orgasm! Orgasm! Yeah!
Boy, you preachers, kids. When people talk about the big one, what might they be referring to?
I'm going to say penis.
Good answer. Yes. Well, you're her husband, and you're clapping harder than anyone.
Yes. I'm securing myself.
Name something a person might put on before making whoopee. Joe.
Condom.
You just firing them off today, ain't you, Joe? Just ripping them off. You bet you're real big popular down at the church after this, pal. Let's go. Got the condom on. Hey, Chris, name a fish you're afraid of.
A killer whale.
A killer. Yeah! Killer whale.
That's all right, dancing. It swims.
It swims. Now,
I know it swims, but the key word in this sentence is fish. We looking for fish, big fella. I don't want to press you about it.
You good.
I don't want you to bust me in the back of my head. Name a dance that's sexy.
Well, the only thing I can think of right now is the booty pop, booty pop.
Hey!
What?
I just told your daddy is watching. Hey.
Your
daddy is watching.
You.
Your daddy is a pastor. You can't be in here with this. So good. I'm so good at all this. Lord, I hope. The preacher's daughter just said the booty pop. No, no, you've been given some scary answers. Her father's a pastor.
Yes. Yes.
He's right there.
Yeah. What's up, Bob?
Well, Dad, here we go. Name something it might feel great to ride on in the nude.
Well, I think it'd be great to ride a horse.
Okay. Yeah, that'd good answer. Awesome.
That'd be answer. Awesome. That'd be awesome. That'd be awesome.
Ride a horse naked.
I'm
going
to have to try that one, man.
Don't try.
I am. Let me try.
Hey, don't tell me. Married and I'm trying to get to heaven in it. And a naked woman on the horse is not good for either one. Name something that might feel great to ride on in the nude.
I'm going to say a hand glider.
Married. Hand glider. Yes. Just in the wind. You done just jumped your naked tail off a cliff. Greg, where's your like mind at, man? You just on the mountain, you just running and you just.
I've been watching the Travel Channel.
That's right, boy.
Hang gliding.
Hey, take his winnings and make it happen.
This
Steve.
Is yeah. gonna be really good. Big Chris. Name something that might feel great to you riding on in the nude.
I'm gonna say a unicycle.
Yeah, yeah, good answer. Okay. Okay.
You let Big Chris get his neck and tail up on a unicycle. Floating in the air? Name something a dieter might do right before being weighed.
Well, you try and spit a lot.
Try to spit a lot.
Yep.
Good answer.
Just spit a lot. Yep. That'll get the weight down. What you doing, Steve? Steve, what are you doing?
I'm trying to lose weight.
I'm trying to lose weight right now, man. How much you think you're down? About a quarter of an ounce?
I have a special talent I want to share with you. Is that okay?
Well, yeah.
Gobble, gobble. I'm a turkey gobbling champion.
No, I can't do that.
Yeah, had a great
See, it sounds, when I say it, it sounds like everybody get the hell out of here. Name a discreet spot to put a tattoo.
On your penis. Definitely discreet.
Ooh. Ooh.
don't even like it when the doctor holds me and says, cough. I'm gonna give it to a guy that drinks beer with long hair and a ponytail with a needle in his hand. He's a sketch nut. Let me ask you a question.
Yes, sir. No, I haven't.
I know you haven't, but if you did, though,
okay,
what would the tattoo be? I'm just curious as to what you would put there.
A fly on the tip.
Penis. She's the champ, you know. She's the champ. This isn't just any turkey goblin. This is championship god. One more titty. Huh? Thanksgiving, huh? You're thinking Thanksgiving, right? Okay, I've been working on it. Okay, show it to me one more time. I ain't gonna be able to get that right there. How about a turkey that's, see, my turkey
wounded?
Has, yeah, wounded and being chased. Oh. What do you do, Joe?
I am a unemployed fitness instructor. Really, I'm a retired construction worker.
Jim, you know the crazy part? I wasn't ready for that, right? So I'm sitting there and he says, I'm a retired fitness instructor. And I went, oh.
Yeah, okay. I'm a work.
Man, I went, boy, that layoff must have jumped off a long time ago, man. Curtis. How you doing, man?
I'm doing wonderful. I wanted to compliment you on your dress.
Thank you,
and
sir.
I wanted to let you know that the mark of a well-dressed man is the ability to tie his own bow tie. Yeah. And I have one for you.
Woo! There you go.
Well, I don't understand.
That looks nice. Uh-oh. I like it.
I could do it.
Let me see.
It'd be a little hard, but I can do it. I need my mirror.
All eyes on you.
No, you can't say uh-uh.
I said all eyes on you. I don't, but all eyes on you.
Yeah, but see, I can't tie it without a mirror, though. I gotta have a mirror.
You're doing good.
I'll tie any kind of tie to who are you?
Who am I?
You know, you ain't even supposed to be in there.
I am the Tory.
This is between me and Curtis.
But I'm always
the bossing woman down here.
But I'm the baby cousin.
You the baby cousin.
The baby cousin.
But see, you gonna have to learn.
Face.
No, I didn't mean to do that.
I do want to cook.
Yes, I
had to jump back with you. That's right, we stand strong as a family.
Crazy. She's going to be single forever.
Oh! No, you did not!
You're crazy. See, you're a very beautiful girl. You're very attractive, pretty smile and all like this.
I got the number one answer, too.
And you got the number one answer. Mm-hmm. And talk all the time.
I do.
So I don't know. I don't know when you think the man gonna ask you to marry him, but you're gonna have to be quiet so he can get it out. A lot of women ain't married today because the dude ain't had a chance to get it in. Man, you married her yet? I wanted to, but hell, she won't stop talking. Name something you like soft but firm. Sheila.
The P word.
The P word. You know, Miss Sheila, I gotta ask you, because, you know.
I'm a little Christian girl.
Well, not if you're saying the word I think you're saying.
What do you think I'm saying?
I don't know, but I'm gonna let you say it, though. All of America's waiting on you. Go ahead, anytime you're ready, baby.
Would it be a penis?
Well, Miss Sheila, that was the question. Name something you like soft but firm. That's the first thing popped out your mouth, so let's just go see if it's up there. It's the P-word. Name something made for your dog that you'd like to use for your spouse.
A dog dash.
Ladies, can I ask you ladies a question? Why is there such anger attached to your answers? A dog bed, a bone, a dog dish, the dog house. Y'all ain't real.
Well, just so you know, we have been married to totally of 148 years, all of us. So we know all these answers. That's why.
148 years total?
Yes, yes.
That's pretty good there. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well, we only got one answer left, and you just said...
Dog dash.
Yes.
Same anger. Same anger. Dog dash.
Here we go.
Dog dash. Name something a woman buys to take the place of not having a man in her life. Sheila.
The vibrator.
Miss Sheila?
Yes, Steve?
You know, the last game, you started this game off the exact same.
I know, that's why I hung my head.
And then your answer the last show was the P word.
Yes.
And now this show, what's your answer?
The vibrator.
And you've been married how long?
It'll be 38 years in December.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
But the secret is out. A vibrator. Give me Tori. Give me Marshall. Let's go. This is the jazziest grandmama in the whole country. Hey, ladies, point values are triple here. We've got the top four answers on the board. Name a reason grandma might take out her false teeth.
To shake somebody's hand.
To shake someone's hand.
That's a good answer. Good answer. Yep.
Shake somebody. Grandma, take them out, shake somebody.
Not the front door.
Joni?
I got it. Woo!
You got it,
Joni? Mama's bringing it home.
Okay, well, let me set it up for you, because Mama's bringing it home.
Woo!
Well, we're going to find out. You got two strikes. Name a reason Grandma might take out her false teeth.
To clean them.
That makes a lot of common sense to me.
Yes, it is. Woo! Clean them.
For the win, to clean them. Shannon, how are you?
Doing good.
Good. What do you do for a living, darling?
I am in grad school to be a chiropractor, just like my dad. And I like ballroom dancing.
I'm talking to my wife about it.
You should consider it. It's full contact.
I'm more of a slow dip and grind type guy. So I met my wife, I was slow dancing with her.
Oh.
Yeah, I was on it. Okay, how do you do it?
You just dance in
a box. Come around here.
All right.
Show me how you do the look. You got Nashville boots on. Okay, how would I do with my wife?
We're gonna do the salsa. Yep, and together. Together.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it's good to me. Yeah. That's not to the beat.
That's okay.
That's okay. Very good, I'm telling you. Dancing with the stars, baby. Oh.
Man, that was good.
Yeah. Your wife gonna be doing that tonight. We'll be naked, though. All right. Shannon's a ballroom dancer, gonna be a big-time teacher one day.
She was very good at it.
And I'm gonna be on Dancing with the Stars.
Perfect.
And I'm gonna win it as soon as I figure out what they pay.
Well, you got your look, so what do you need money for?
No, that's exactly who I need money. You ain't fooling me, lady. I got a mirror. I need all the money I can get. Ain't like I'm Denzel Washington or nobody. Terrell. How you doing, man?
Good, man.
What
you doing?
What do you do for a living? You all are twins.
Twins, yes, sir.
I have twins. I recognize that.
Oh, right. Yeah.
But, of course, we already know that's the better.
No, that was the wrong. That was the wrong.
He fired that.
No, he got it right.
I know. He did. So, who's the oldest?
I am. 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Wow.
Can't you tell? He looks older. He looks older.
Come on, now.
Twins. Come on, man. We look just alike. Terrell, what do you do?
I own an auto repair shop in Charleston, and also
good,
a charter
man.
Bus company.
Darryl,
how
you doing, man? What do you do, man?
I work for a major insurance company. I work auto claims.
Okay, good. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I see the game. auto claims, auto repair.
Well, you know.
I see it.
He write the estimate, he send them to me.
Bet you busy. Liz, how you doing?
Hi, I'm great.
Okay, straighten
big
the diamond
fan.
Up right there.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. I have a good husband.
I know.
I like the bald man.
You like the bald man? Yeah. Yeah, the people always tell me, why'd you cut your hair? Because my wife asked me to. When it's bald, they do things with it. Don't look down now, Liz. You know it's true. JB, how you doing?
Good, man? How are you?
Good, good. What do you do for a living?
I'm a colon and rectal surgeon.
Rectal? Just the guy I've been wanting to talk to. This prostate exam. You know, with all of the technology that's available to man today, why? Why has no one come up with a simple way that you don't have to lower a man's dignity? You ain't here won't talk to you or make it pleasant, you won't put a glove on, and you're gonna say stupid stuff. I hate it, because you lay on your side, pull your knees up to your chest, smile. I'm not smiling. I hate that. I wanna take this finger right here. I wanna push it in your eye right now, JB.
Can I make a recommendation?
You have a recommendation.
I have a recommendation.
I am listening.
Find a surgeon with small hands.
I can't take it no more. This guy is killing me. Name something a person might do while being kissed.
Stick their tongue out.
Hey, JB, did you just demonstrate it? Do it again, JB. You a nasty doctor, you. Stick your tongue out. Yeah!
Right.
What would you do if you received an obscene phone call from a woman?
What would I do, or what would 100 men do?
Hey, my man.
Masturbate.
I'm just saying 100 men, not me.
I'm thinking.
From a woman.
Man from a woman, right? Not me. 100 men. You're asking me, right? And not me, Steve. No. It's gotta be number three. No?
Hold on one second. I gotta go get something.
Expected that one from me.
Yeah, Dave, you said that. Dave had said that. I went, yeah, Eugene, I'm surprised.
100 men.
100 men. No, no, no. No, you're not dumping this on 100 men. You said 100 men are me. Right after me, you said masturbate. I'm just assuming, because nobody in here was thinking that. But you. Masturbate.
Oh, I thought for sure.
Oh, and to make it even worse, you can't believe it's not up there. Did you see his reaction? Oh, God. Well, Gene, we ask 100 women to fill in the blank. I judge a man by the size of his what?
His package.
It goes with the other one.
Eugene, I think you're coming into your own right now. I think you're discovering who you really are, and I think it's coming out on national TV.
Come on, package.
The package!
Yeah! I'm gonna go with hands.
I judge a man by the size of his hands. Yeah. Throw your hands up, baby. Name something of your husband's you'd love to throw out.
Old underwear.
Old underwear. Name something you feel self-conscious about doing alone. Liz.
Masturbating?
Wow. That's my sister.
My wife. Yeah, I gotta tell you, Chang family. Family full of doctors, y'all at the house. Y'all at the house just tripping. Never heard such a thing on a more consistent basis in such a nice looking family. This is ridiculous. And Liz, you're gonna stop acting like the little gentle housewife. And you're gonna be the wild, hot mama that you really are. Take the glasses, throw them off. Shed yourself, be free. Let them know it's about me. Get naked on top of the refrigerator. Masturbation. Julie, name something you need if you wanna be a good kisser.
I'm gonna say you need to be attractive.
You need to be.
Yeah.
Hey, whoa. I gotta tell you though, I don't think that's necessarily true. One time I was having a bad week, and I met an ugly woman, and good Lord Almighty, this woman could kiss. And if you shut your eyes, yeah. Woo! You need to be attractive. Hey, Ryan, tell me something you got a secret stash of.
I'm gonna say, not that I have any, but maybe nudie magazines.
Nudie magazines, yeah. Julie, let me ask you something. You know, I know this is a game and everything, but when your husband gives an answer like that, does it kind of throw a little light bulb up?
A little bit.
See, Ryan, here's the time where really your marriage is more important than this game. And sometimes you just got to take an X.
I had to preface it, though.
Yes. See, what you do is just, you don't know nothing about that. You ain't got no stash or nothing. Save your marriage, man. You're here trying to win this damn game and lose that pretty little thing down there.
How about liquor?
Liquor.
Yeah. All right now, little alcoholic.
Ryan? Ryan, thank you. Turnabout's only fair play.
You know what I mean?
Just found out that she might be hiding some liquor at the house. Got to throw you off a little bit.
Put them together, we got a good thing.
Such a guy. I love guys just put it together. Hey, no problem. You got liquor? Hey, I got porn. Hey.
Party.
Rihanna, how you doing?
Good. How are you doing, Steve?
Good. Okay. What you do for a living? You just lost. I was just shaking your hand.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. Don't understand. Because I've had several people do me like that.
I don't want to be one of those people.
Oh, no. I just walk off. Okay. I just say, okay, no problem right here. Hope you lose. You know, excuse me.
Steve.
Yeah. So I'm just a guy, you know, sorry.
You're not just a guy, you're Steve Harvey. You're a big deal. Woo!
I guess you're right. During a medical exam, name something you'd hate to find out the doctor had also used on the patient before you.
Steve, I'm gonna have to say a Johnny.
Yeah. What's a Johnny? Yeah,
I like the robe they give you.
The robe that they give you. That's called a Johnny?
It's called a Johnny.
I didn't know that.
No, it's nice and open in the back.
Yeah. There you go. Woo!
Yeah. Woo-hoo. Exactly, Steve. Woo!
You know what I always do to mess them up when I go? I put it on front way.
Yeah.
Tied right there. I'll be standing there. Come here, it'd be open. I'll be standing out here. I'll mess them up, Jack. I put it on and just open it a little bit. What's happening? How you doing? How you doing today? So Johnny a little small. Yeah, yo Johnny a little small. it's Megan.
It's Megan.
Megan.
Just put a little Southern drawl to it.
Megan.
Megan.
Well, Megan rhymes with bacon. That's what I do. I just say it like that, and then you can just take it to the bank. Like, I'm from the country myself. West Virginia, to be exact. Daddy was a coal miner. It's all right. What's your daddy used to do?
My daddy works for a trucking company.
Works for a trucking company? Uh-huh. Same thing. Probably was hauling the coal my daddy was digging out the ground. He's passed on to the great beyond right now. How old's your daddy?
50.
Your daddy's 50?
Yes.
Why am I talking to you?
I don't know.
I'm old enough to be your damn daddy myself. You're just a little child. How old are you, 21?
I'm 27.
27?
No, I'm not. I'm 26.
Well, you're lying to me then. What are you hitting me for? You the one told a lie. Andrew, how you doing, man?
How you doing?
I like that tie.
That's yours.
That's a Steve Harvey tie?
That's right.
I knew I loved this guy for a reason. I said I like this tie. You can fix it right there, man. I love you, man.
I kind of like yours.
You like this one right here?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Let's stay away from this one, buddy.
I collect ties.
You collect ties?
Yes.
Wow. How many ties you got?
So about 50.
50 ties?
Yeah.
Wow. That's a nice
one. It's an expensive one, too, Steve.
It's an expensive?
That's the white.
Oh, this is the white. Oh, wow. The ties are expensive.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so let's talk to you then. Yeah. You're an attorney, you're having problems. Your husband's just buying those expensive Steve Harvey ties, and I already know what that tie costs down there, and you gotta be kidding. I bet you've got 50 pair of shoes.
There we go.
Hello, snap,
there we
snap.
Go. Let's talk about those.
What we talking about? You understand?
That's right.
Yeah, I shut that down for you, Andrew.
What a man.
Talking about your tie.
That's right.
She mad at you because you got 50 ties.
That's right.
You ain't said nothing about them shoes.
None.
Nor can you.
None. I would not dare.
Wouldn't open your mouth. You no. love those shoes, don't you?
Oh, I love them.
Yes.
I love them. I'm married to them.
Yes. Hey, Carmel.
I see.
What do you do, darling?
I'm in healthcare sales.
Healthcare sales?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. Well,
I'm excited to see you.
Don't worry. 10 years ago, this could have went somewhere. Okay, baby. I mean, Carmel. Hey, Amanda, name something a man might be holding when he's in the bathroom.
His penis.
Well, I'm not in the survey. Oh, boy, she just stops that right away. Don't come over here looking at me, mister. You know it's true. When last time you went in there, what'd you do? You ain't in there handling it. Who is? I guess it was me. It's penis. Megan, tell me something you put in your mouth, but you don't swallow. Wow. You ever walked up to somebody and saw the look on their face and you just know? I walked up to her and I went, whoa. I mean, man, you talk about the cat that ate the canary look. Megan, I'm gonna ask you this question. I want you to think about this show and all the years it's aired, how many families have enjoyed this wonderful form of Christian entertainment. So find a way to give me your answer and keep it where we can all be working when you're done.
Well, I'm a pastor's wife, but I will say this out loud, they're sperm. You know it's up there, Steve. Everyone knew it. It's up there. We're going for the money.
We're going for the money, so that makes it all right. It doesn't matter that I'm a pastor's wife. Ticket to hell is worth $20,000. You know it's up there, Steve. No, I don't know a damn thing is up there. What you ain't gonna do is drag me into your little nasty world. I don't know nothing is up there. Oh, Steve, you know what's up there. Oh, hell, I know what's up there. I have kids. Now. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It ain't up there, yeah. Now, it ain't up there, yeah. Hey, it ain't up there, yes. Yes, we can all still probably go to heaven. All right. Hey, 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 uh-huh, uh-huh. Hey, what you get for saying it? You're gonna stay on the air. Family Feud, 20 more years. Eric, let's go, man. We talked to 100 men. Name something you put on to be sexy.
Leather pants.
Good answer. Good answer. Boy, you ain't cleaning them carpets. You're something else, ain't you? Man, all right, ready. Let's go. It's hot outside. Let's go. I know it's hot outside, but doggone it. Give me them hot, wet, sticky, tight, leather pants. Hi, Stacy. How
Steve.
You doing?
I'm good.
Good. What do you do, ma'am?
I'm a full-time grandmother / nanny, and I also take care of my husband's goat farm.
Huh? Where do you live? in with Nashville?
Them, with them in Nashville, with Michelle and Jason.
Oh, you, whoa. Okay, you live with Michelle
yeah,
and Jason?
Yeah, I'm there like nanny slash mother-in-law.
In the same
mother-in-law.
House? You saying that? Yep. But this is your mother?
My mother.
Yep.
Jesus. That's all right. Come on, dog. That's all right, man. You're about it. All right, man. Yeah. God, yo, man. Ooh, this is ugly, man. How long this been going on, Michelle?
Like three, almost 4 years.
Ooh, I'm sorry. This is an allergic reaction.
We get along great.
You get along great. Who? Let me tell you something about poor Jason. A man in his own house, let me tell you what he wants to do. He wants to just walk around in his drawers sometimes.
No,
he want to go to the refrigerator.
Him.
Nobody's stopping him. Your mama is in the house, and you got six damn goats walking around. And hell, you gonna walk around in your shorts with the goats. This man wants to get up in the middle of the night, go to his refrigerator, open it up and just stand there with his drawers on drink water out of a jar that's just his.
That's right, Steve.
That's what your husband wants to do. Daryl?
Yes, sir.
Pretty much anything you say, gonna start an argument at the house. We ask 100 married men, that's you, Daryl. Name one thing your wife could do that would improve her appearance.
Wear sexy lingerie.
My man.
That's
the one you wanna do. Yes! That's the perfect answer. That's perfect. That's nothing about her personally. That's something you want, help you to desire her more. That man is a genius. Sexy lingerie. Yes. Name part of a daily routine that newlyweds can turn into a sexy experience. Misty.
Taking a shower.
Taking a shower. Let's take a shower. Shower together. I'll wash your body, you wash mine, yeah.
We're gonna say it can be sexy washing the dishes.
Mm. Well, rub-a-dub-dub.
That right.
Wash, scrub. Oh, man. Al.
Oh,
my
yeah.
Man. Woo! My man. Right yeah. There, baby.
Oh, yeah, I
yeah.
See it.
Yeah, you like red?
Any color.
I'm driving the car.
Absolutely.
I'm your daddy. That's it.
Might let my wife drive.
Oh, Al, you gonna let the wife drive. See, Al, when the wife ain't here, men like her, we say yeah. Anything we want to.
Well, that's true.
See, we taping right now. This gonna be on TV one day.
All right.
And your wife yeah. Gonna hear this.
Yeah?
So let's go back. Let's just back up a little
bit. Rewind it. Okay,
yeah, so Al, let me ask you a question, man. So the kids ain't driving the car, huh?
No, I think I give it to my wife.
Love this stuff right here, boy. See that? That's my man. See? Yeah, see that? See, ladies, y'all think men are stupid. We really ain't. We ain't that dumb, man. We got good sense. Just give us a minute. Sometimes we gotta run it back through. How you doing?
Just fine, how are you?
I got you. You ain't gonna give me no more, I told you, try it again, go ahead, try it again. Right there. Name something you wouldn't want to be in the middle of if there's a fire drill.
Doing the nasty.
Good answer.
Doing the nasty. Right at this moment, what are you in the mood for?
Making love.
My man. Making love.
Oh my goodness.
Here you are trying to be decent and everything.
Trying
give
to
a nice
Christian answer.
Got a man sausage up there. Yeah. Name something a person might use to crush their nuts.
A nut crusher.
A nut crusher, yeah. What else? Jeff.
I'm gonna go with a knee. Huh? A knee, like, I might be thinking of the wrong nut.
Boy from New York representing Maryland. Your knee. Name something a woman does during sex that tells you she's bored. Daniel.
She don't make any noises.
She don't make any noise.
I mean, you ain't doing your job when she ain't moaning. Daniel! Daniel!
They're not making any noises.
She answers the phone.
Good answer. That's all right. Good job, Harvey. Good job. All right. Yes. Yes.
Hello. Nothing. Just come on over anytime you want to. Okay, see you, Mama. She answers the phone. Name something you did as a kid that your parents still don't know about. Anthony.
Have sex.
Look at your brothers right there. It's... Have sex. What are you doing? There ain't in your family. Name something a dumb person can do to look more intelligent.
No offense, okay?
Yeah.
But they could wear a suit.
They could.
No offense.
The first time a person has ever looked at me and thought that's why I had a suit on. Person with his dumb, ignorant self with a suit on. Wow. We ask 100 men, name a kind of plastic surgery you'd consider if it weren't so expensive. And
a penis enhancement.
Last show, I asked you, did you have a boyfriend? You said you did. He ain't gonna understand why in the world that would be the first answer you fired off right there. Okay, let's just go. It's okay. I know, it's okay. It sounds like, you know, people don't think their answer's out, but you gotta know, you know, you can only say what's on your mind. The big P implant. Give me Lane. Give me Derek. Let's go. How old are you, Derek?
I'm 28.
Wow.
Yes.
Do you believe in magic? You got to. You got to say yeah.
Yes, I do, Steve.
That's what I thought. Yes. Yeah. Okay. Santa Claus is coming to town. Said, name a type of nut people serve at parties. You said, cashew. We need 41 points. Survey said. Hi, Till.
Hello, Steve. How are you doing?
You're such a nice little girl. How old are you?
I'm 19. No confusion. Yes.
I got a son just turned 20 today.
You trying to pimp me out?
Hey. I'm trying to what?
Pimp me out.
I was thinking about maybe the two of you meeting somewhere, but let's just shut this down. Because what you ain't finna do is if it don't work out. Steve Harvey pimped me out. Name something you'd be surprised to find you still have to do every day in heaven.
Gonna go with walk, Steve. Walk.
Walk. This is the first bad answer you done gave. You know you've been to church and you have heard old people sing the song.
Yes, Steve.
I'm just gonna walk around heaven all day. I'm just gonna walk. I'm gonna walk around heaven all day. I'm just gonna walk heaven all day. Walk around that city of gold. Walk. Marlise?
Yes.
How you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
What do you do, darling?
I'm a high school Spanish teacher.
Caliente.
Oh.
Huh?
Yes,
huh?
I know what that means.
Yeah. Yeah. Bet you don't know how I meant it, though. Yeah, I'm a grown man. I don't know but one word. That's it. It's just depending on how you say it. What's the worst question to ask a girl on a first date?
Do you have any kids?
How would you do it, Stan? Just let me ask
something
you.
Like this. By the way, do you have any kids?
Oh! You! How dare you! If you live to be 100, name something you hope still there with you.
I'm definitely speaking for myself. My dog, Molly.
Well, Jay, your dog's gonna be 700 years old.
But she watches this show, so.
Well, you know,
Molly, I gotta give her a shout out.
I gotta tell you something. Molly needs to just go head on, okay? 107-year-old dogs. What'd you say, girl? How did you know that? Name something that makes a man sleep like a baby. Melissa.
Liquor.
Liquor. Liquor. Shay?
Sex.
All right now, Shay. Yeah, rock and roll, baby. In the treetop. When the wind blows, little Shay starts to rock. When the bow breaks, yeah, down will come cradle. Big sexy Shay is up there. Rocking you in the cradle.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. Some sex. Name something David Hasselhoff has done that makes people cringe. Brandon.
See Pamela Anderson nude.
All right, let's go see. I don't know where that came from. Gunner makes us cringe when he, every time he sees Pamela Anderson nude. Brianna? You don't even know who the hell he is. Please give us another one. Oh, no, we got to go here. Donna?
He's drank too much and made a fool of himself.
He's drank too much and made a fool of himself. Well, y'all gonna pass a play.
We are going to pass.
Hey, Lawrence, how you doing,
How's
man?
How's everything, Uncle Steve?
What do you do for a living, buddy?
Well, I'm a massage therapy student at the Anthem Institute in Jersey City.
You yes. gonna be a massage therapist? Yes. Yes. That's the move you came up with, huh? You single, ain't you?
Yes. Yeah,
yeah. Anyway, in the world, your wife gonna let you go down here and do this. This is a single dude. What would I really like to do? I'm with you, though. We all know that love can lead to marriage. What does marriage lead to?
Divorce.
Man.
Good answer.
Divorce. Yes. Where are you folks from?
We're from Appleton, Wisconsin.
Appleton, Wisconsin. And Bob, what do you do for a living?
I'm an autism therapist.
Okay, that's
yes.
nice.
Yes. And now, can I say hi to my two boys that I work with?
Yeah.
Hi, Alec. Hi, Chris. I made it!
Bob, let me ask you something. You've been waiting all these years to get here.
Yes.
The magic moment is here.
Yes.
Give me a word used to describe a T-bone steak that a woman might also use to describe a man.
Juicy.
Right? Ooh. Ooh, Miss Bob. Miss Bob, you go to church?
Yes.
Ooh.
I'll probably have to go more now, yeah. right?
Miss Bob, looking for that old juicy man. Name something a man might not want the woman he's hitting on to know he's wearing. Charles.
A thong.
A thong. Pop, you just went for it, huh?
Just went for it.
Thong.
Thong.
Threw it out there.
Threw it out there.
Don't want them to know you got it on.
I ain't got it
just
on.
Just got the string then right up the middle, right there. Mm. Looking for a thong. We talked to 100 single women, and boy, you like girls, don't you?
I do, of course.
You shut your eyes when you say it.
No, it's just because I was going
back.
I know.
Don't even worry about that. You like girls? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Name something you'd be surprised a man brought with him on a date.
No clothes.
Number one. Obviously, you ain't been in the dating game in a long time. So you don't know what a guy bring out here. Secondly, you just thought if a guy would be pretty shocking, he's just sitting up there naked. Ding dong. They in the window, they see him.
Amen.
He's standing there just naked. Jimmy.
Hey.
Came, set up naked, no clothes. Name the biggest complaint that women have about the way men kiss, Mr. 20 years old.
I'm gonna say too much tongue.
That's a good answer, James. Now, let's just talk about how you know that.
I mean,
that ever happened to you? Somebody said.
I plead the fifth. Not to go cool. speak.
That's cool. You can say that to your mommy and your daddy, but I'm the game show host. We don't have a fifth in here. Too much time. Name the biggest complaint women have about the way men kiss.
Too much mustache in the way.
Too much. Too much mustache. It's okay. Name a part of the body that muscle men love to show you.
Their butt.
All right, now. Jimmy. Jimmy just at the house. Jimmy, you at the house just... No, I know that's what you're doing. Plus, you're a fireman, been going up them ladders and stuff. Boy, you got a nice set of ham back there. Your butt! Tell me a way you try to make it up to your wife when you mess up.
How about give her a nice massage?
Yeah!
Jimmy.
Yes, sir.
That's what you try to do?
Oh, yes. She likes it.
But see, it can't be nothing that's for you. Take the stupid look off your face, because you know I'm right. I try to give her a massage, and I'm just standing there. Why are your eyes in the back of your head? Boy, men, man, we the worst. Give her a massage. Name a command you give a dog that you might give your lover in bed.
Okay, my church is gonna hate me for this, but eat.
You talking about the dog, but I can tell you right now, that ain't your church no more. Eat!
Here comes mom.
Hail to the queen.
You're right. You got
hey,
it, see.
Hey, Miss Madeline, how you doing?
Baby, I am so fine.
I see. I'm off the market now, but if I was, I'd be at your house Sunday. Eating. Yeah, no, I meant. I was talking about for Sunday dinner. I promise you I was not thinking. I was thinking of Sunday dinner. That's
I'm
what
the
mama.
Last of the Creole cooks.
No, mama, I was talking about eating dinner. You know, Sunday you go over to country people's house Sunday for dinner. When I said that then, y'all a nasty audience up in here. Y'all trifling, man. Name something you should do if you're arrested. Ashley.
Close your eyes.
Close your eyes. Oh, okay, then the police officer go away.
I'm sorry, I just said arrested.
Close your eyes. I was not understanding that at all. Close your eyes. Sir, step out of the car, please. How you doing today, Alexa?
I'm great.
I'm happily married.
Great.
She owns one half of everything I have. It is cheaper to keep her. Alexis, how you doing?
I'm great.
Great. Well, name something an ugly man can do to make himself better looking.
An ugly man can make a lot of money.
Ugly man, make a lot of money. Yeah! That'll do it. Watch this. Am I cute to you?
Of course you are, Steve.
I thought, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Back then, they didn't want me. Now I'm hot, they all on me. Hey! I'm gonna be in so much trouble with this ass, man. Name something you might have to stand up to do if you had hemorrhoids.
Cook food. You'd have to stand up to cook.
Okay. Good answer.
This is not our area of interest.
It's not our area.
Who the hell you know?
It's better than the club.
Scoots a chair up to fry some chicken.
Some people by themselves.
Man, I can't see nothing. God. Squeeze it up. Name a reason you might not like the pair of underwear your wife bought you.
Well, I don't know if it's the same, but I'd say style. You know, maybe you don't like boxers or tidy whities. Tidy whities, boxers, it's just not your style. Do you know what I mean? I don't know what you wear. but you might not like tidy whities. You might not like boxers. What do you like? Is that too personal?
I like bicycle drawers.
Okay.
Because they don't get jammed in you ever.
They sound comfortable.
They're very comfortable.
Okay.
I didn't want to bring that up, but you all had a lot of pressure on me.
See, I'm a counselor. I bring these things
I know, because all your answers is long.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Do you remember what I said?
No, hell no, because it was so long ago. This ain't a regular game. We're going up for, Tidy Whiteys? Tidy Whiteys! And number two. That's why, see, that Miss Marilyn. Miss Marilyn, see, that's why I buy bicycle drawers. Because they come down to right here, you can get them 9-inch and 6-inch. I have to get the 9.
Okay.
Thank you for sharing that. Yeah.
How you doing, Dave?
I'm wonderful. How are you?
Congratulations.
Thank you.
This your first one?
It is our first.
Wow.
It's a boy.
It's a boy. How many months are you?
I am 6 months now.
6. Mm-hmm. You ain't gonna be sleeping no more. Now you tired because you didn't sleep the night before. Now you trying to rock this baby to sleep.
How you doing, Steve?
He can do it though. He can do it.
Cause I got 7 kids.
7.
Let me tell you a little secret, man. A lot of people ain't gonna like this, but this is how you get a baby to go to sleep. Your wife ain't gonna appreciate it, but this is what I used to do to my twins. Because I used to try to get them on the same schedule. Take your baby and hold your baby up, and gently, very gently, just blow in their eyes. Just very gently. Not hard, just a cool breeze. And I'm telling you, they do like this. And then it's just too much for them after a while, and they just go, man, hell. I'm telling you. DeRico?
Yes, sir.
What do you do for a living, man?
I work for a branch of the Department of Homeland Security, sir.
Oh, okay. All right. So you got anything to do with us taking our clothes off at the airport?
Yes, sir.
You ain't the guy with the gloves on.
Yes, sir. The blue ones.
You get the first time that happened to me. And that dude starts snapping on them gloves.
Yes,
you
sir.
Know, I'm over 40, so usually when a man slaps on gloves around me, I'm thinking something else about to happen. You all don't get this joke.
I do. I do. I get it.
These little young cats here just looking at me. Well, see, when you're 40, you have to get a prostate exam. You don't even know where your prostate is, do you? You're gonna find out, though. Well, let me tell you something, fellas. When they tell you where your prostate is, you ain't gonna like it. And then it's a man, big old man, about that size right there. He gonna go looking for it. He gonna have a glove on. His hand gonna look like a catcher's mitt. And you know what he gonna do? He's gonna put his hand in there looking for your little prostate. All right, DeRico. When a wife is mad at her husband, what does she make him do by himself?
I'm gonna say have sex. Yes, sir. You're on your own. You're on your own.
So, let me ask something.
Yes, sir.
How would she say that to you? Just give me an example.
I guess you'll say, well, you already know what it is. You're on your own. That's it.
Just go on and get started.
Pretty much. That's your leisure time.
At your leisure.
At your leisure.
Well, take your time. You take your time, because show don't take it with me.
Good answer.
Good answer. Having sex.
That's all.
Yeah, boy. My little front row fellas, they went with that one. Might not know where your prostate at. bet you know what the pickle is, though. Name something you wish was a little bigger.
Oh, man, oh, man. This, I don't have this problem, Steve, but I'm going to say...
Hold up, partner. No, no, no. See, what you're not going to do is give us the speech before you give this answer right here. Corey, name something you wish was a little bigger.
Penis.
Points.
Well, let's bring the pregnant wife in here. Stacy, when he said that, did your knees buckle a little bit?
Only because I don't know why he said that.
Good answer!
Good answer! Good answer! Good answer!
Big boy! Big boy! Get your swag on. Hey. Yeah. Corey, boy, she saved you.
She saved me.
Corey wants his little tallywagger to be a little bit more tally on it. My meat. How you doing?
Good, Steve. How are you?
What do you do?
I teach first grade, and I have a sweet baby 18-month-old girl, Ava Grace. Yay, Ava Grace!
Yeah. You talk like that all the time?
Most of the time.
All the time.
I bet the kids is entertained. Okay, this one, I want you to come in, I want you to imagine that you're coming into the class, and I want you to come in and say, as exciting as you can to make it sound good, kids, today, we're working on colors and shapes, and it's gonna be a blast. Do it any way you want to. How would you do it?
Good morning! Today, we're working on colors and shapes, and it's gonna be a great day in first grade!
All right, Ms. Tam, name something that would be almost impossible to do without a tongue.
I'm trying to visualize how you would lick without a tongue.
All right, now, Ms. Tam. I'm trying to visualize how you will lick without your tongue.
I think it's a good answer.
Yeah. Lick. Letitia?
Letitia.
Good. How you doing,
darling? I'm good. How are you,
good,
Steve?
Good. What do you do?
I'm a recovery specialist for the bank during the day. At night, I'm a stand-up comedian.
What made you start that?
They've been telling me all my life I was a fool.
Exactly the same thing I heard. You know what I'm saying? I even had a teacher told me in the sixth grade, Miss Blandon, sit down in the back, Stevie. You ain't gonna ever make no money acting a fool. Ta-da! Name something an angry girlfriend might do to get back at her cheating boyfriend.
Now, please don't think I would ever do this.
Okay.
But we're gonna go with kill him.
He cheated, that's all. He just had another chick on the side, that's all it was. Just kill it, man.
He wouldn't want the other alternative.
Ladies. Oh, do you hear what she said? Well, he wouldn't want the other alternative.
Oh, my God.
Well, hell, go on, kill me then. Kill him! Name something bad that makes people feel good.
The death of an ex.
What is going on?
But it's something bad of an ex. Of somebody who cheated on you.
The death of an ex. Just a reminder, your last two answers have been about killing people. Monica, name something that has a horn.
A shopping cart.
They got a horn on cars now.
the electric shopping carts? They do. I think they do.
They have horns on them?
Somebody blew at me.
I know that's right. I know that's right, Monica. Probably wasn't a shopping cart. The shopping cart with the horn on it. Name something that can never be long enough.
I'm gonna go with a man's private parts.
It's on there.
You shut up. Let me ask you a question, Kendra, before I turn around. Did you understand the question? Man's private parts. I gotta tell you something, Kendra.
Yes?
That's some pretty disturbing news to a lot of men in here. So, fellas, just know this. No matter how proud you are of yourself, not enough. Name something your doctor does to you that he doesn't enjoy any more than you do. Mark.
Sticking his hand in your butt.
Huh?
What? Sticking his hand in your butt like a proctology visit.
You mean finger, don't you?
Yeah.
I'm dead right now. That's a whole nother exam if he got his whole hand in there. Buddy? Mark's doctor puts his whole hand in Mark.
Yes! Yes! Woo!
Name something your doctor does to you that he doesn't enjoy any more than you do.
Fondling you?
What is y'all's family's doctor's name? Y'all getting roughed up down
well,
there,
children. You have to do
doctor.
That for your physical.
Doctor's fondling you. Yeah! Give me a word that rhymes with wrinkle.
Sprinkle.
Yeah.
Sprinkle.
That's a good one.
Sprinkle.
Yeah. Look up there. Sprinkle. Oh. Oh, you can say it as loud as you want. Sprinkle! Sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle! Sprinkle, sprinkle, sprinkle! Okay, cool. Yeah. All right, Dave, let's go again.
Minko!
Hey, Matt. At Dimple, that wasn't that bad of an answer. Watch this. Name a job where you lose a lot of customers if you had body odor.
Stripper.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go.
A smelly stripper. Name something you do in the mirror when no one's looking.
Take medication.
Give me an example of what you're talking about.
Any medication, Steve.
Cough
vitamins.
Vitamin cough syrup.
Yeah, that's right, Steve.
You know, you looking? You see? I'm finding out how to do it. Yeah. Took that cough medicine. Going on downstairs to the club. Taking medication. Talk to 100 married women. Give me a reason that your husband couldn't get hired as an exotic dancer.
He doesn't look good naked.
He does not look good naked. Bam! What does she mean by that? Well, you don't know what she thinks. I'm sorry.
He's not big enough.
I'm scared to say it, but it's the question.
I'm not even gonna look over at the judge. I just need you to be more specific. What do you mean
he's not big?
His private parts is not big enough.
Yes, Steve, for an exotic dancer. I'm playing to win.
You're married, right?
I am. This doesn't apply to me.
I know. I didn't want to ask you. No, the question is, we have name a reason your husband couldn't get hired as an exotic dancer. That's all. We just asked you why your husband couldn't get married. They ain't say nothing about them people all out there why their husband couldn't get married. Now, you know, I'm just putting it out there. Is he here today?
No, he's not.
Well, when this air... Little fella don't need to be out there. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing. Jeff.
Sister. She's never gonna forgive me for this either.
No, she's not.
Lindsay, you're not the sister.
No.
Where's your sister right now, Joe?
Probably hiding somewhere.
Is she in the building?
Or hunting for a weapon.
They got a new device now. It's called YouTube. You're gonna be a major star, Joe.
I'm sure.
Yep, Big Jeff. His sister. Yeah. Well, you got seven other people gonna be in the same room in hell with you.
Sounds a little strange, but how about the mirror?
The mirror.
You see how we're pregnant?
Y'all was having a good time. No wonder y'all pregnant. Y'all just so good and tried everything. Been all in the mirror down there with the little girl down next door. You got a baby doll in your hand. Come here, give me that animal right here. You just been in the house practicing. Woo. I bet y'all stuffed animals is laying on the bed like, yeah. Oh, yeah. I got to be the luckiest bear in the world. Because you're all attractive girls. I'm sitting at y'all's house going, what a life. Hey, Steve, what are you? I'm a stuffed animal. Don't you wish you were something else? Uh-uh. They'll be home in a minute. Yeah, go on, say it. I want to hear this.
Orange.
An orange. What were y'all doing at your house? You got a pillow? You got this poor baby doll need therapy? You in the mirror? You using your hands? And that stuffed animal is waiting on y'all to put all that mess down. I better come on, baby, let's do it. An orange. Name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
And maybe he's excited to go on his date?
Uh-huh.
I have to be more specific, don't I?
Yeah, because I ain't never put no excitement in my pants. Go ahead, Mackenzie.
Boner.
Huh?
Really upset again?
What did you say?
Boner.
Station TV.
can say that on TV? You can say that on TV? What are y'all clapping for? You said boner. You said, I mean, you didn't ask me if you could say that. You said it, and then you said, do I have to make you say it again? I didn't make you say it in the first place. Let's get this clear. Let's get this clear. This was Little Miss Fassie's answer. Oh, this show ain't gonna make it 3 years. I'm gonna be off the air. When Richard Dawson did this show, I never heard stuff like this. I don't remember any of this. Now, 2011, 2012, y'all just say what you wanna say. Now I gotta turn around. I've gotta find a Christian way to say what you just said. Let's just say someone is saluting the troops. How y'all doing? Let me tell y'all something. Look at the last one that just went up. A pitch tent. Don't say that when you come out the hole. Ready, break. Hey, Joseph, how you doing, sir?
Hey, how you doing, Steve?
Good. What do you do?
I'm a sales associate, and right now I'm single and ready to mingle with ladies.
So. Hey, Joseph. This ain't really about the game right now.
I came on the wrong game.
You just really threw what you did. I'm a sales associate, but I'm single. I'm ready to mingle. So what kind of sales associate are you?
Oh, I work at Club Tarjay.
Club Tarjay.
Tell you how out of touch I am. I'm sitting here going, Tarjay. That's high-end retail. Club Tarjay. Yeah, just take your time, Joseph. All right, man, let's go. You got to be careful. You got two strikes the Fitch girls can steal. Name an occupation whose theme song might be She Works Hard for the Money.
I'm going with prostitute.
A prostitute. Just say that. He been down there thinking of his answer for 5 minutes. How can I say this? A prostitute. I high-fived him for at least using the right term. I turned around, the board got a hoe on it. All right, Bull family, here we go. We had plenty of time. What are y'all doing? Hey, what's wrong with y'all? The whole time I've been talking with the ladies, you've been in a huddle. You can't, once we come out the huddle, we need one of these ants. Y'all just hollering. Big Robert, we got this, we got this. Come on now, 20,000, we got to get this. All right, Derek, here we go. Here's your chance. We talked to 100 women. Name something that's more satisfying than a man.
Sexual toy.
Woo! Sexual. Hey, Big Robert, was that your answer? Say it! We gotta get this 20,000! Sexual toy! Big Rob, of all the United States presidents, which one would look hottest in the Speedo?
I'm gonna go back a little bit.
I know.
But you have to put Abraham Lincoln up there.
What you say, with the beard, the hat,
hey,
Speedo, bam! Abraham Lincoln,
ooh,
signing that emancipation. Just went over with a Speedo. Yeah.
That's right.
Because he probably had one on. Everybody don't like me signing this emancipation, I'll tell you what. Yeah, right there. Abraham Lincoln in a Speedo. Yeah! Raphael.
How are you, Steve?
What do you do for a living, sir?
I am a salsa singing entertainer.
Oh, this is going to be too good for me. God, let me tighten up your tie before I ask you to sing. Raphael, you're a salsa singer.
Salsa singing entertainer, baby.
You got that?
You know?
Let me tell you something. I'm gonna give it to you. Yes. 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 I love you.
I love Listen. You too. I love you.
Richard Rosa, who runs my suit collection, was a Cuban singer and dancer.
Okay.
He runs my clothing collection. So you got to do a little something for me. Just do something for me.
Let's see. I'm going to do something in English and clave. Give me a hand here. Clave, what they call clave.
All right, now, come on.
We're having a good time playing Family Feud. I want to take home that money and take that part home too. Hey. Family Feud. Bye, y'all, baby. You got it, babe. Yo, turn it. Steve, you got to turn.
You tell me to turn, I turn. I got no problem. I drop it like it's hot. I do all that. Give me Jovan. Give me Rebecca. Let's go.
This is gonna
be a long game, I can tell. Well, Javon.
How's it going?
Yeah, Mr. Controversial. Thought that was pretty cute up there,
dude. It was pretty cool. Yeah. It's all about 20,000 up here. That's all it's about. You know, I'm not here to make friends.
Now, come on with your crazy self. What is he, your nephew?
That's my sister's son.
Your sister's son? Yeah. That's your nephew. You don't even want to call him your nephew. He didn't even want to say it. Ain't my nephew, that's my sister's son. I don't even know, I told him not to put him on the show. When we were picking the five people for the show, first thing I said was, don't bring that crazy boy down here. He don't like shaking people's hands. All right, Jovan, let's go. Name something that might be referred to as juicy.
I'm gonna say your pockets, money.
Money might be in your pocket. Your pocket. Yeah. Money pocket juicy. Get all juicy pockets. Pocket money juicy. Juicy. Big old juicy pockets. Got them juicy pockets. Boy, that pocket look juicy. What's that in your pocket there? What's that juice? Juicy, got the juicy pants. Tell me a candy bar that might describe your mate in bed.
Butterfinger.
What? It's going on in your bedroom. Butterfinger. Wow. Butterfinger. Miss Karen, I gotta ask you now. When I asked you about a candy bar that might describe your mate in bed, why'd you say Butterfinger?
We've been married 35 years. How about that?
Okay.